Welcome viewers, today's topic is persistent ductus arteriosus. Normally the ductus arteriosus closes soon after birth, but in this anomaly it fails to do so. Persistence of the ductus is often associated with other abnormalities and is more common in females. Now the pathophysiology of PDA. During fetal life, before the lungs begin to function, most of the blood from the pulmonary artery passes through the ductus arteriosus into the aorta. Persistence of the ductus causes a continuous AV shunt from the aorta to the pulmonary artery, since pressure in the aorta is higher than that in the pulmonary circulation. The volume of the shunt depends on the size of the ductus. But as much as 50% of the left ventricular output may be recirculated through the lungs, with a consequent increase in the work of the heart. A large left to right shunt in infancy may cause a considerable rise in pulmonary artery pressure, and sometimes this leads to progressive pulmonary vascular damage. Now the clinical features. With small shunts, there may be no symptoms for years. But when the ductus is large, growth and development may be retarded. Usually there is no disability in infancy, but cardiac failure may eventually ensue, dyspnea being the first symptom. A continuous machinery murmur is heard with late systolic accentuation, maximal in the second left intercostal space below the clavicle. It is frequently accompanied by a thrill. Pulses are increased in volume. Enlargement of the pulmonary artery may be detected radiologically. The ECG is usually normal. If pulmonary vascular resistance increases, pulmonary artery pressure may rise until it equals or exceeds aortic pressure. The shunt through the defect may then reverse, causing Eisenmenger syndrome. The murmur becomes quieter, may be confined to systole, or may disappear. Now what is the investigations? Echocardiography is the investigation of choice, although the persistent ductus requires specific echocardiographic views, such as from the supraesternal notch, to reveal it. The ECG shows evidence of right ventricular hypertrophy. Now what is the management? A persistent ductus can be closed at cardiac catheterization with an implantable occlusive device. What is this? Implantable occlusive device. Closure should be undertaken in infancy if the shunt is significant and pulmonary resistance not elevated. But this may be delayed until later childhood in those with smaller shunts, for whom closure remains advisable to reduce the risk of endocarditis. When the ductus is structurally intact, a prostaglandin synthesis inhibitor, that is indomethacin or ibuprofen, may be used in the first week of life to induce closure. However, in the presence of a congenital defect with impaired lung perfusion, such as occurs in severe pulmonary stenosis and left to right shunt through the ductus, it may be advisable to improve oxygenation by keeping the ductus open with prostaglandin treatment. Unfortunately, this treatment do not work if the ductus is intrinsically abnormal. This diagram showing the persistent ductus arteriosus. There is a connection between the aorta and the pulmonary artery with left to right shunting. There is the presence of ductus arteriosus where blood flows to the aorta to the pulmonary artery. Thank you, viewers.